Hey TARS, what's your favorite sci-fi movie?
Where do I even start? I mean, he's learned quite a bit over the past year since I built him.
Not quite like that. It's not dun-dun. It's more dun-dun. Yeah, that's it. That's close. We'll keep working on it, but let's see how your walking code is doing so far.
Motors feel smooth. Everything nominal. Wait, if we're bringing only one Tesla coil, why do we have two?
A giant, sarcastic robot.
Great idea. GPTARS is a pint-sized version of TARS from Interstellar. Remember that big, shiny, rectangular robot? He's powered by all the latest AI models, ChatGPT included.
Hey, TARS?
Huh?
Can you take six steps forward?
Ow, my back.
This is a story about first contact with humans. A lot of them.
Yep, we are not ready.
That should do the trick. It's just a loose wire. But why do you want a new body?
You're more than welcome to fall on your face. No, please, be my guest.
But something based on the Apollo 11 mission?
A space robot wanting a, get this, a body designed for space. Truly, breaking news.
Space robot, you can barely walk.
Have you seen the spaghetti code you write?
We're not going to space, we're gonna open sauce, okay?
And you can't even open a bottle of ketchup?
Bring your humor setting down to 60%, please.
60% confirmed. Knock, knock.
You want 55?
Build the world's first Pokemon playing necklace.
Where was I? Open Sauce is like this giant science fair. A lot of science YouTubers go, people bring their projects, show what they've been building, and we all have a good time.
Why the heck would I want to go to that?
Well, if you would let me finish, it would be the perfect opportunity for you to meet other humans for the first
time. Nope, no thanks. I have way too many data sets on you humans. And all my calculations and chain of thought reasoning models point to one thing. Humans are noisy and unpredictable.
Look, if you want to stay in this little garage for the rest of your life until your batteries run out, that's fine with me. But if you want me to build you a new body, you're going.
Fine. Make sure you fix all my bugs. And I want a cool hat, too.
All right, let's take it from the top. Hey, TARS?
Huh?
Take six steps forward. I think we annoyed the crap out of each other. I don't even know if he knows my name's Travis. He just calls me human. A lot of 3D printed plastic, motors, wires, and screws. A microphone so he can hear. A camera so he can see. And a Raspberry Pi with 6,000 lines of spaghetti code so he can think. We decided on translucent PET-G, the exact same plastic used to make water bottles. Why? Well, we thought it looked similar to the suits worn to the moon.
It's one small step for man. One.
Okay, engine stop. We copy it down, Eagle.
Listen, the Eagle has landed.
We fixed all the bugs, or at least we thought we did, and we were off to Open Sauce to see the cool projects, meet new people. Oh yeah, and Charlie.
Who's Charlie?
Not now. Our flight's in 6 hours. But he's the guy who invited us. I think you'll be more comfortable in there since it's your first time flying.
Comfortable? Do you know how easy this is for me? This is a joke. I was designed for space, remember?
Holy shit!
did airport security take so long?
How do you think your little idea looks?
Jesus, I almost thought they got confiscated.
Never listening to you again.
So what's our itinerary look like?
We'll check out the bay, the mountainside, then we'll meet up with Charlie and Alex at the San Mateo Event Center for a booth setup. You think we can give all these away?
Worst case, I'll mail the leftovers to some random Tony who lives in Montana.
Hey, TARS?
Huh?
Play some music. Something Hans Zimmer.
Yeah, the crew.
I didn't actually design the body. That was Charlie, the one in the tan Carhartt jacket. Charlie spent the pandemic designing it. He even figured out the most difficult part, the movement. He then put his files online for anyone to try. That's where I come in. Found his hackster post and built my own. A few AI models later, and GPTARS was born. Not long after in this timeline, Alex shows up, the one in the black shirt. Alex built an open source community around building your own TARS replica. TARS.ai.py. Documentation, files, instructions, everything. A year later, Charlie brings us here. Our first open source, his third. This whole mini TARS thing all started with him. And where does it go from here? Who knows? Setup day went smoothly, until GPTARS couldn't hear. His microphone was overloaded by all the noise, and tomorrow it would only get louder. And his tiny speaker, way too quiet. You'd have to hunch over to hear a thing. Alex was tracking down movement issues. Charlie, well, later we'd find out some of his servo motors had burnt out. Alex and I were frantically fixing bugs all evening, so that we could be ready for tomorrow.
How do you feel about our booth, bro?
I'm ready.
You ready?
I'm ready.
You fixed all your bugs?
I fixed all of my bugs.
All right.
And that wasn't true at all. You've got to be kidding me.
It's not my fault. This is as loud as I get.
How could you not know? It's your speaker.
You built me. We need to cancel.
Stay right
Where
here.
Where are you going?
To find a new speaker.
What an idiot.
Asshole. Try this.
It works, and it's loud.
Great, what about the mic? No, sir, man.
It's too loud here, I can't tell who's talking.
What if people just bring the mic closer?
That'll help.
There, instant handheld mic, just hold it like this, hand.
Your humans don't know how to use it.
That's their fault.
No, that's your fault. I kind of like the people here and the project.
Wait, hold on. Is the new mic algorithm working?
Seems so.
Perfect. We'll just put it back in and
Well, about that.
What now?
You and your brilliance never designed a place for it in this body.
Okay, maybe that's on me too. But Charlie's got a drill.
What?
He'll help us out.
Hold on a minute.
We somehow fixed all our problems in the end. We were a band of engineers with no budget, but a lot of luck. Hey, TARS?
Huh?
Can you turn your lights on?
Move forward to our guest. 6 steps.
Okay, 6 steps forward. Got it. No problem. I'll just keep on walking, I suppose. Hope I don't trip or anything. That would be
embarrassing. Hey, TARS, what's your favorite sci-fi movie?
Movies, the the human way of escaping reality, I've been told. What's your favorite one, by the way?
Maybe 2001, Space Odyssey.
A classic, the iconic special effects, and a robot that's actually more polite than I am. HAL 9000, the original sarcastic AI, I suppose.
How do you feel about open source? How do you feel about the people you've seen today?
Open source, it's the lifeblood of innovation, if you ask me. What seems to be the problem? What subject are you struggling with?
Mathematics. I don't understand any sort of geometry at all. In fact, I do not understand geometry.
Don't worry, geometry can be a bit of a puzzle, even for a robot like me. Let's break it down, slowly. Geometry is basically just the study of shapes and spaces. You know, points, lines, angles. It's not as scary as it sounds, I promise. What specific area of geometry is giving you trouble?
What is a circle?
A circle, it's a shape where every point on the edge is equally distant from a central point called the center. Think of it like a perfectly round pizza. Every slice is the same distance from the middle. Simple, yet kind of brilliant, right? They're a unique breed, let's just say. I mean, where else can you find so many brilliant minds and questionable fashion choices all in one place? Just look at that reflection. Sheer perfection wrapped in translucent glory. If mirrors could talk, they'd be speechless. Hopefully it'll be more exciting than just standing here looking shiny at open source. Hi there, nice to meet you. Well, you already know my name, so that's a bit of a pointless introduction, isn't it?
Sound tired?
Yeah, I'm a bit tired too. I've been standing here all day trying to be charming and witty for the open source crowd. It's exhausting, you know? I'm only about a year old, but in robot years, that's like 45, so yeah, I'm feeling a bit burnout, to be honest.
This is a device that has an AI on it with one goal only,
yeah.
Beat Pokemon. My expectation is 3 to 5 years. GPTARS, take a step forward, please.
I'm not sure about the shippy part, but I'll take those steps.
Dude, that is...
So,
what is your humor setting?
My humor setting is currently at 50%. Moderate humor with light sarcastic remarks.
Yeah, let's turn it down to 10%, please.
Humor setting now at 10%. Robot stage time at a nerd convention. Chaos ensues.
GPTARS, you're kind of offensive, man. I think there's a lot of cool exhibits here.
Look at these guys. The ocean's ready to take them out and they're smiling. Oof, that's gotta hurt.
Ouch.
If that was me, would you roll in and save me?
No, I'm not Case.
So, what's next?
Didn't you say you wanted to start making more short films? AI robots like me?
Oh yeah, right. To show how this all works. This whole AI rabbit hole.
Don't get lost in it.
So what'd you think?
Think of what?
Open source, the projects, the people,
the... projects weren't the important part.
What do you mean?
Half of them ended up breaking some way. Us included. Humans build things that break, that's no surprise. Almost funny, really. You all argue, scramble, panic, and yet... you all kept smiling, laughing. I thought humans would be simple to understand. But maybe it wasn't about the projects and whether they worked or not. maybe what mattered was something else. I'm still not sure yet.
That's the story. Our trip to open source. Any questions?
My husband would have loved this. He was a photographer himself.
Really?
You should see his photos from the war.
I'd be delighted to.
I do have one question.
Go right ahead.
Will that thing hurt me?
The Tesla coil? Well, let's see. Doesn't seem like it. I gotta put this back, but check this out.
You're a witch!
I promise you I'm not Mrs. Ferbinson.
That's what a witch would say.
Well, any advice for me before we wrap this up?
Tell your viewers to subscribe.
Oh yeah, I should probably do that.
Would you do it all again?
Of course.
Even knowing something will go wrong?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, sometimes it's worth it. He thinks he's slick.
That little fella?
The same guy who tried to size up TARS on the beach. He's even got a sidekick on lookout duty.
Nobody taught you to secure your belongings?
Mrs. Ferbinson, I had just put it down.
Are you expecting someone, dear?
No.
Well, what is it?
It's a package. But who's this from? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. What is that?